But that is what I love about America.
We are a diverse nation, and because of that, I think we should all come together. So I've been trying to find my inner 50-year-old female from Wisconsin, and I've developed this character that I did last night, and I'm going to do for you all tonight. There's a caveat to it. You're going to have to give me some ammunition here. Her name is Tammy. She's a mother of 12, a Catholic from Kenosha, and I'm going to go back into my character again here tonight, and Tammy's going to give you all some dating advice, and or some marital advice, or just advice on whatever you all want, okay? So we're going to have some fun with my voice, and the minute it gets annoying, feel free to pull out that 12-gauge and just right on the head. So anyway, we'll go into Tammy. Do I have any suggestions or advice from anybody that they would want from her? Anybody?
Trump.
No, it's relationship advice.
Cheating girlfriend. Cheating girlfriend.
No, you want to talk about our president?
Yes.
Okay. So my husband Randy, lovely gentleman, we met about 35 years ago at the University of Wisconsin. He was employed. It was great up until NAFTA. I'll never forgive Mr. Clinton for that one. I'll be honest with you. But anyway, he's been unemployed since about 1993. And, he's just sitting there in the basement drinking and listening to Gavin McInnes and, I don't know what they're calling it now. It's the alt-right stuff. But, so that's what I think about our president. I'll never forgive Randy for voting for that guy. He's a son of a bitch, and I didn't know what the fuck to do. You know, I didn't want to vote for the Clintons because I can't fucking stand that family. But, you know, what's a woman going to do? And, you know, my daughter, she's a lesbian down there in Chicago. And, I was just a fit to be had. So I guess that's what I think about our president. You get me going and a few Miller Lights and I'll start talking about the Packers and then eventually Mr. Trump. We have a good time. I do have something in common with a lot of Trump supporters, and that's that I like to drink ethnic beers that I bought at Fiasco. I don't know if you have this Corona. That's some good shit. You know, I'm not a big fan of the letting in the immigrants, you know, but they're bringing this Mexican beer. I don't know if you guys have had that. That's some fancy stuff. It's called Sol, which means sun. I didn't know that about 2 weeks ago. See, my daughter, she was taking Spanish class back in high school. And she's a cop. Well, no, she's now a lesbian down in Chicago. But, you know, she drinks that Mexican beer with her friends. And she was telling me that means sun, and I didn't know. I didn't know. So we drink that now. Well, I do. Randy doesn't want to have anything to do with Mexicans. He likes the Taco Bell, but that's about it. So anyway, that's what I think about our president. I'm not the biggest fan. I'll be honest with you. We're waiting for our tax break, and it's just not coming. They've been telling us it's going to come in the mail, and I just don't know. I can't trust that man. You know, he's a New Yorker. And you know what they say about New Yorkers? You know how they're lying to you if their mouth's moving. So, you know, would anyone else like to talk to Tammy about their problems? Anybody got anything?
How do I get
your number? Oh, shit. So here's how Randy and I first met passionate love back in Madison. We were at a Jewish fraternity party, and I never met a Jew because it was Wisconsin in the 70s. You know, we all liked Led Zeppelin, but we didn't know what the Jews were. And we knew they were a thing because we had heard about the telecast, but we didn't know about that. Anyway, so here's how you get Tammy's number. You take her into a fraternity room, give her a few strolls. Beer that made Detroit, you know. Give her a few straws, give her some Jim Beam, and then she'll get down to that Catholic girder belt. Now, I know you think what you're thinking, the Mormons are the ones with the girder belt. No, this was Catholic in the 70s. We're a different breed. And so you get her a few, you know, get her a few drinks down, and Tammy will open those legs up faster than they're going to build those jobs in Chicago. Anything else that Tammy can help you out with?
Ingrown hair.
Gay pride parade.
Well, you know, Sir June's coming up, And I want to go visit my daughter down there in Chicago. They got a lot of queers down there. I know that's not completely correct from these days, but we're going to go to the Cubs game. It's kind of like a gay pride parade. You got a lot of guys with their beer bellies hanging out.
Sure.
And, you know, she's going to take me down to Pride. Now, I've been down there with her a couple of times, and what I don't understand is why it looks like a bag of Skittles. Like, you know, they've committed to this, and this is a whole, you know, rainbow thing, and it's a lot of unity, but I'm just not getting it. I don't taste the rainbow. I don't know what they mean by that. And, so, you know, I enjoy the gay pride parade from time to time. I'm not a bigot just because of how I sound, sir. You know, I eat a lot of cheese and processed foods, but I got another life. You know, we just because the jabs aren't coming back, that's not my fault. Anyway, how else can I help y'all tonight? They told me if I did the stand-up comedy, it would let out a lot of my anger. See, when you're a wife trying to keep 12 kids together and your husband's just drinking in the basement, you gotta fucking find a way to get it out. And so I just come up here and man, you know, it's ended badly a few times. Not saying I have any DWIs or anything, but you know, the Kenosha Police Department knows where to look. So, how else can I help you, lovely people? That's it. That's about right. Yeah. You do look like a nice couple. How long you two been going at it? Let's be honest, honey. You're only riding that hobby horse for fun. Come on out. Oh, 8 months. Have you seen his tally yet?
Yes.
That's nice. We were good Catholics. We didn't wait. You know, we went for it there. He showed me his pinky, and I was just like, holy shit, let's try the rest of that bag. So, you know, yeah, I can tell you the story. I doubt I did, because I don't know you people, but I can tell you the story here when I took my aunt, I can't stand my sister. She's from Minnesota. She's full of shit. And for no other reason than just because she's so fucking pampas with her crap. She thinks she's better than us because her accent don't stink. And I'm like, honey, I don't know what you're talking about just because you finished cabbage. I got a cup for this crap. So anyway, she took me up to the Hormel factory there in Rochester. And she was, I don't know if you know this, they have Tabasco Spam. Right? I liked it. It was spicy. It had a little bit of variety in my meal. We're living off about 4 weeks' worth of it now there in the Walker household, but we're having a good old time. We're keeping it together. That's all I got, you know. We're keeping it going. Anything else I can help you guys with? Some relationship advice? Some relationship advice?
Celebrity relationships.
What?
Celebrity relationships.
I don't understand that Kim Kardashian. What does she see in him? I mean, he's clearly mentally ill. I mean, he made a lot of sense there when he was talking about the gangs in there in Chicago, but past that, I don't know what he was talking about. Free Harry Hoover, what are you talking about, you know? I actually supported him there because I don't know if you know about the Gangster Disciples. They got that logo with the Star of David, and we support Israel in our house. And so I'm all for that. They seem like a lot of nice people. But what do I know? I'm a naive woman. Anything else I can help y'all with?
Today's music.
It's crap. When you made Sweet Passion of Love to Jessica by the Allman Brothers, there's no going back. My son. We don't know if he butters his bread on the other side, but he was, he's 24, he lives in Milwaukee, and he was telling me about